Okay, you know him from the shows Real Rob and New Girl. Now he has a new stand-up comedy show. Welcome, Monty Franklin. How are you?
Hi, thanks. Thanks for having me.
It's so good to have you. So we actually, by the way, I want to tell you, I dressed up for this because I took off my Uggs.
I put on shoes.
You did. I never have seen you in a suit in all the times I've known you.
I'm still wearing skate shoes, though.
That is
something
true.
Wrong with me.
Yep, little tennies there. Now, you and I actually have a little history because we did a pilot together that you wrote.
Yes.
And it's funny because I remember you told me, you said, come audition for me. And I said, what do I do? And you were like, just be yourself. Then later, I looked at the description, by the way, of the role. And it was a promiscuous, desperate cougar who drinks a lot and is bad with money.
Just be yourself. Perfect. Got the role.
Anyway, we have a clip from the Manny when we actually worked together. So take a look.
Ooh, athletic young visitor. Janice Excelsior.
G'day. Monty. How's it hanging?
Oh, the left is fine, but Dr. Nichols wants to revisit the right. Anyway.
Okay, so
Dana didn't even know we were filming. That was just her regular day-to-day activities.
You know, I cannot believe I didn't get an Emmy nomination for that.
It's coming. It's in the works, I believe.
No, you're doing a comedy show coming up on March 1st in Oxnard.
Yes, at the Oxnard Levity Live, March 1st.
Oxnard Levity Live. Tell me what are some of the funny things you normally talk about.
Normally?
Yeah.
I don't know what I normally talk about.
Or at least what you can talk about here.
You know what I want to talk about is my anxiety watching the Winter Olympics.
Okay, tell me.
They can kill themselves at any second. Whole time. And like if you're watching the swimming in the Summer Olympics and they get their stroke wrong for a second, you're not going to notice.
No.
But if they land wrong, they just give up. The judges must be so harsh because they just throw their hands in the air and go, well, I've ruined everything. Don't worry about the triple axel and the three quadruple McTwists I just did. My pivoting foot was off by 11 degrees. I'm embarrassment, and they just give up.
And I didn't even notice the mistakes half the time. And
no,
they're like,
I don't
know. Oh.
I like when the figure skaters fall down, though, and they try and pretend they didn't, and they just get back up and like, ah, and they smile, and at the end they're smiling, and they go, oh, remember when you fell on your butt?
Yep.
We all saw that. Like, that happened.
And we actually have a clip of you from doing stand-up comedy. Let's take a look.
Like, my favorite time to live in America is Christmas, because that's when people come up to me, and they'll go, oh, do you celebrate Christmas in Australia? No. No, Jesus was only in the Northern Hemisphere. Yeah, Christ only died for the sins of those above the equator, so...
Very, very... Because I actually think I asked you about Thanksgiving, which you were like, no.
That happens all the time. People come up to me and go, oh, are you going home for Thanksgiving? Yeah. I'm going back to Australia where my Australian family get together around our Australian dinner table and we thank God America was discovered.
Exactly. As you should. As you should. Now, what are some of your other interesting, because you're from Australia, so what are some of your other observations about Americans? Interesting ones.
I don't know. I love the American culture and stuff. Like, people do that to me, actually. They say to me, do you celebrate Independence Day in Australia?
Right.
And like, yeah. We celebrate your independence from the British while we're still under the ruling of the British. Why would we do that? I get these questions. Look, LA and New York are usually pretty good, but if I go in the middle of the country somewhere, some of the questions that I get, like that Independence Day and stuff like that.
Right.
Oh, man, it's fun.
And you know what? I swear, I've actually asked him those questions, so it's not that funny to me. No, you are actually, you tour with Rob Schneider a lot from SNL. Yes. And you guys have been writing partners together. He was actually in The Manny, too.
Yes.
You guys have worked together a lot.
A little role for me in The Manny. I roped him into it as well.
Right, exactly.
That's me and Real Rob dressed
and by
as
the way, I thought
psychopath.
I think you look really good right there.
That's my best look, I think. Sideshow Bob, homeless...
No,
There you go.
No, you guys are working on a new project. Can you? It's actually the funniest thing I've ever heard. I know you can't talk about all of it, but what can you tell us about?
Rob and I, we're working on a movie, and it's going to be filming in Australia later this year.
Right.
And so that means it'll come out in around 2025, I think. I don't know. I don't know when movies get finished. But I can't tell you what it is. I can't tell everyone exactly what the storyline is, but it's a true Australian story, and it's ridiculous and unbelievable. And it's going to be really, really funny. And Rob's helping me out tremendously with it.
And it has to do with an animal that you would never imagine.
I don't know if I can say too much, but it does have to do with a traditional Australian animal that may have made the whole country look ridiculous.
It's hilarious. Okay, so you can see Monty, by the way, live at the Oxnard Levity Live Comedy Club on March 1st. And lucky for you, there's a special for KTLA viewers. Email oxnard@comedykoala.com. That's oxnard@comedykoala.com. 20 double passes for the show up for grabs. So good to see you.
I bought you a koala.
Oh, I have a koala from Australia. Thank you so much.
It's probably from China.
You clean up nice, by the way.
Thank you.
Much better than that other thing that we just saw. Thank you.